Hi, welcome once again to Senior Focus. I'm your host, Bill Adams. And Senior Focus is a show designed for adults over the age of about 50 or so. And we try to bring you information that you can use in your daily life. We want to thank Armstrong's Channel 20 and 100 and Greg Roten for bringing the show to you. And also the Austin Town Library and the Public Library System, because we use their public meeting rooms to film the show. And today we have Brenda Heidinger, who is the Associate Director of the Mahoning County Mental Health and Recovery Board.
Yes.
And thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
We're going to talk about a number of things that might pertain, I guess, especially to seniors, but this could also help all the citizens of Mahoning County.
Correct.
All the services that you provide.
Absolutely.
Why don't we just start off with some of the basics? I know a couple years ago you merged, there was a merger between
Correct.
Mental
in,
health, yeah.
In Ohio, when the law was created back in the 90s, there was a allowance for the 10 largest counties, to have two separate boards. So here in Mahoning County, we had a mental health board, and we had an alcohol and drug addiction services board up until February of 2015, when we merged those two boards into the Mahoning County Mental Health and Recovery Board. Mm-hmm. So we now address all mental health and addiction issues for the citizens of Mahoning County, ensuring that services are available and people have access to them.
Right. And before we go too far, where are you located at? Where's the board actually at?
We are actually located in the Children's Services Board building, which is at 222 West Federal Street, Suite 201. That's downtown Youngstown, 44503. So we're right on the corner of Federal Street and Hazel Street in downtown, for people who are familiar with downtown.
Okay.
We don't actually do direct services at the board, but we do take referral calls very frequently to help people find services that they may need. And so they can always call us at 330-746-2959, and we'll help them find the services they need.
Right. And before we go too far into it, we also, before people get confused with numbers, I know, again, that would be a good number to contact the board at the administrative end, but you like to mention 211.
Correct. We also encourage people to use 211. If they're looking for services, 211 can always refer them to the service they may need. So 211 has a list of every service in the county. They also cover Trumbull and Columbiana counties, so anyone in this area can dial 211. And get information on any type of service, anything from housing to mental health to addiction services to utility companies, and how seniors might be able to get their utilities at a reduced rate. So 211 is a great resource.
Mm-hmm. Well, you mentioned that. So there are programs for utility reduction?
There are programs out there for budgets and different utility programs that 211 is very versed on. Mm-hmm. We don't deal so much with the board, but a lot of times when we're dealing with a senior or someone else with a mental health issue that may also have a disability or be a senior age, we refer to 211 to get into those programs.
Right. Now, we're happen to be filming this in winter. Mm-hmm. And, of course, this can apply any time during the year. But in the winter, I think things like depression and those issues can rise among seniors, among everybody, really.
Among everybody. We're seeing some depression. And so, you know, this time of year, we don't get out much. In the state of Ohio, we're kind of trapped indoors, especially older populations, because you don't like to walk on the ice. None of us do. But it gets especially scary when it could be your hip. So people stay in. They tend to isolate more, not be with their friends. And so we see some increase in depression around this time of year, just not getting enough light and enough interaction.
So what are some of the programs that the Mental Health Recovery Board can help with for people who, you know, again, have some concerns, either it's depression or anxiety or things like that? Where would they go to?
There are options available for people in Mahoning County. So for those kinds of issues, some of them your doctor can handle. But if you feel like you need to talk to a counselor or talk to someone, you know, more of a conversation, you can call Turning Point Counseling Center, which, again, calling 211, they'll get you the number.
Okay.
Turning Point Counseling Center is available. Compass Family and Community Care has counseling services. And Catholic Charities, which serves anyone, not just people of the Catholic faith, has grief and bereavement groups. So if people are experiencing grief or bereavement at this time of the year, it can be especially difficult.
Oh, sure.
They can also be connected with Catholic Charities for those services.
Mm-hmm. Now, are there fees on some of these services? I mean, most seniors, I'm thinking, are under Medicare. Mm-hmm. So do you work with insurance companies? Do these, yes, these organizations do that?
Or? All of these organizations work with Medicare. Mm-hmm. So they will take Medicare for any mental health counseling. Medicare does cover that service. If they do not have Medicare, or if they have Medicare and Medicaid, Medicaid also will cover those services.
Mm-hmm.
And then as a board, we have a levy that's on the ballot every 5 years.
Okay.
That the citizens thankfully vote for and support, and mm-hmm. we appreciate that. We use those dollars to provide monies to these agencies to provide services for anyone who cannot afford them and doesn't have insurance that covers them.
Oh, good, good. So again, a call to 211 is a start for this.
It's a start for all of this. You mm. can then be hooked up with any agency depending on what your issues are.
Mm. Now, with seniors and things like suicide, are you finding an increase in that among the senior population, or are there concerns about that issue?
We're not really seeing an increase locally, but what we do know is suicide rates for seniors are higher than average.
Okay.
So, you know, when broken out of the population, the suicide rates are higher. That comes down to the loneliness, the being stuck inside, not being around people. And so getting out and enjoying your friends and family and engaging maybe with your neighbors if you need to, mm-hmm. just to try and have some engagement with people, mm-hmm. helps people, or get into counseling if that's what you need.
So the help hotline then is basically 211. I mean, you
correct.
Call.
Yep. If you dial 211, you get Help Hotline Crisis Center. They answer all the 211 calls mm-hmm. and do all that referral. So they have volunteer phone people who answer the phone who will look up whatever you need and help you out. It's also available on their website, or you can find services on our website as well. Mm-hmm. But for those who want to just make a phone call and have somebody help them find it, 211's the way to go.
Oh, good. That brought up a question. Mm-hmm. You know, we've been talking about senior services for seniors, but like with Help Hotline, where you need people to answer the phones, are there some volunteer opportunities that seniors might have with some of these programs?
Absolutely. I know Help Hotline regularly uses volunteers. You can call 211. They'll tell you how to get into the volunteer program. There's actually a week-long training that they offer, mm-hmm. and then they offer updates on that training, and you can volunteer any hours you want because that is answered. That phone line is answered 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Yeah, I would think there'd be a lot of talent out there, you know, among people
absolutely.
Who are retired and maybe now are looking to give back to the community or contribute. Again, we were talking about some of the mental health issues.
Mm-hmm.
What about the recovery end, you know, with maybe medication issues with seniors?
Sure. And in a senior population, we see a lot of medication issues, whether it's mixing medications because you see multiple doctors who give you multiple prescriptions.
Mm-hmm.
And so you have to ensure that every physician knows all the medications you're taking.
Okay.
Because it's very easy to get those too many of something,
right.
Or get an interaction. Another thing to watch out for with medications is that you're using it as your doctor prescribed. So if your doctor's prescribed you pain pills, and you discover they help you sleep pretty well, but the pain's gone, but you're still taking them for sleep, mm. that could be a bit of an issue, and you really need to go back to your doctor and talk to them about having sleep issues, not just continue to take the pain medication for something it wasn't intended for.
Right.
And then the third issue around medication, especially in seniors' homes, is your family members. So your grandkids, the kid who mows your lawn, the paper boy, the kid who shovels your drive at this time of the year.
Mm-hmm.
Making sure that your medication is secure, especially if you have some of those pain medications in the opiate family, like Vicodin or Percocet or Percodan, any of those. Those are just a few of the kind of the brand names of them that are considered an opiate medication. Those are very sought after
mm-hmm.
as drugs that are abused on the streets, and people with addictions want them.
Okay.
So making sure those are secure somewhere in your house where people don't have access to it. So don't leave it in your bathroom medicine cabinet if you let the kid who's shoveling go into that bathroom.
Right.
Maybe put it in a bathroom off the bedroom, or keep it somewhere where people don't generally go in your home.
Yeah, and I could see if people take it on the road with them in a purse or something like mm-hmm. that could be dangerous in terms of being, you
right.
know, purse being stolen.
Right.
In fact, I think it was NPR, but I was listening to a show. I think the gentleman was in his 60s, and he was in an addiction recovery program
mm-hmm.
because, you know, to this point, he'd never had any issues,
right.
You know, throughout his life, but he had an illness or an injury,
mm-hmm.
and he got onto a medication and, you know, just was not able to
right.
withdraw, you know, get off of the medication easily. And so I guess that is a problem.
That can be a big problem, especially if you've had to take pain medications because of a surgery or an injury, that you might find yourself not able to quit taking it.
Right.
And there are programs out there for that. So there's Meridian Healthcare, Neil Kennedy Recovery Clinic. There are a lot of places that you can find help. Again, 211 has all those numbers and can help you get into those programs and get you linked up with those.
Mm-hmm.
So there are a lot of programs out there. They are for anybody. We see people from age 12 to age 70
okay.
in treatment as well as in long-term recovery. So there's a lot of people that may participate in a 12-step program like AA or NA that are very well in their 50s, 60s, 70s.
Right.
And continue to participate throughout their entire life.
Yeah, we've been talking about medications, but this can also apply to alcohol.
Correct.
Again, you know, talking about the loneliness, and sometimes people mask that by, you know, drinking something.
Absolutely.
And then, you know, it just gets out of hand.
Right.
So, yeah.
Right. And people don't always recognize that one or two drinks a day is considered okay.
Mm-hmm.
Once you start getting into more than that, or if you're drinking more than five or six times a week, more than four or five drinks at a time, you really need to consider whether you're having an issue with the alcohol or whether you're just drinking for the wrong reasons.
Right. And again, this could be anyone in the family could be talking with their senior,
mm-hmm.
their loved one, a friend. If you see some signs of something, again, maybe it's a good idea to call 211 for referral.
It is. 211 can give you information on different programs that are available within the community, and can try to help you find the resources you need for a loved one, even. I talk to family members all of the time who are looking for treatment for a loved one that they feel may have an issue, or they have a loved one who's been arrested on drug or alcohol charges, and so they need to know how they can help that person as they go through that court case.
Mm-hmm.
So we take those calls all the time to try to help people, whether it's family members or the person in trouble themselves, try to deal with those issues.
And we have an aging population here.
Correct.
In Mahoning County. I saw one of the things online, I think it was off of your website,
mm-hmm.
which it was a link in which it talked about, I think in 2020, it's estimated 30% of the population will be 60 plus.
Correct.
And we're pretty close to 2020.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a lot of people over 60. And as you have that, you know, you're just going to naturally, I guess, as part of the population, you have people with mental health issues.
Right.
So it's natural that those people are getting older.
Mm-hmm.
And so you have, we were talking a little bit before the show about not permanent, but in a hospital setting. If
Correct.
People need to go for
Inpatient treatment.
Inpatient,
right.
Yeah.
We just consider that inpatient treatment. So there are a couple options. Here in Mahoning County at Mercy Health, at their downtown St. Elizabeth's location, they have a psychiatric unit, but they also have what they call the Jerry Psych Unit.
Okay.
So anyone over 60 can be put in that unit. So they separate people based on age or gender, because sometimes it's easier to treat these issues if you're with people who you can relate to,
right.
Because of the same age as you, or because they're having the same issues as you. So we have those beds about 20 plus beds here right in the county, mm-hmm. in Mahoning County at St. East downtown. We also have available to us the state hospital, which is located in Massillon, Ohio, called Heartland Behavioral Health Hospital,
okay.
Which does acute care to kind of take somebody in, get them stabilized and back to the community where we can then get them into outpatient treatment. We have an agency called CSN that does intensive home-based case management. So they'll go into the home and actually help somebody with their medications, ensure that they're taking their medications correctly around psychiatric medications.
Okay.
For those people with severe persistent mental illness.
Now, I know for younger adults, there are group home situations, residential care mm-hmm. facilities, things like that. Is there any age limit on, you know, people who could live in those, or do you have younger and older adults in those facilities?
We do. So there are the youth facilities that are inpatient and then or residential, and then as people age, we have programs that take anyone from 18 to 90.
Okay.
You know, depending on their needs. So if it's an older person who has been living with a severe and persistent mental illness all their life and really can't do well in an independent setting, there are homes run through Compass and other agencies where those people can live and receive services right in the home.
Mm-hmm. We were talking with Brenda Heidinger. She is the Associate Director of the Mental Health and Recovery Board in Mahoning County. And again, you're located down at the Children's Services Building.
Right.
On Federal?
On West Federal West Street, Federal. Yes. Corner of West Federal and Hazel.
But as you were describing, you're sort of, I guess, the administrative end.
Correct.
And what you actually do is fund a number of different programs. Do you
Correct.
Have any idea how many programs?
We have about 10 core contract agencies that
Okay.
actually provide mental health and or addiction services. And then we have a host of what we call our mini grants. Again, things we use our levy dollars for
mm-hmm.
that the citizens here in Mahoning County need. So we do things with Big Brothers, Big Sisters, where we train the older volunteer on how to work with a child who may be living with mental illness or addiction within the household. But we also support the Alzheimer's Network.
Mm-hmm.
So if family members are dealing with a person with Alzheimer's and need some support, they can call the Alzheimer's Assistance and Referral Network here locally, mm-hmm. go to a support meeting. We help support those for the caregivers to help their mental health as they try to deal with a loved one that they're caring for.
Right. We've had them on the show,
mm-hmm.
And they're on Market Street.
Correct.
And, yeah, that's a good point, is that, you know, you talk about, we talked about depression and things,
mm-hmm.
but just the stress of being a caregiver is often enough to, you know, cause problems for people.
Absolutely. Being a caregiver of either someone with Alzheimer's, someone with a severe and persistent mental illness,
mm-hmm.
Someone with addiction are all issues for the family members as well.
Right.
You know, when you're dealing with that and trying to help that other person, you have to deal with your own issues. So there are support groups in all of those areas. So there are mm. support groups like the Alzheimer's Network, where you can get support if you're dealing with a family member with Alzheimer's. There is NAMI, which stands for the National Alliance of Mental Illness.
Okay.
They provide family support groups. The Federation of Families provides support groups for family members dealing with children with mental health issues. Al-Anon provides services for people who are living with someone with an addiction.
Mm-hmm.
And all of those are referral sources we can get you referred to, tell you where meetings are, help you find a meeting that might fit your needs, so that you have support in dealing with that family member as well.
Yeah, I'm thinking of a lot of the seniors in the area who
mm-hmm.
are now sort of becoming, well, they're grandparents, but they're
Correct.
Becoming surrogate parents.
Correct.
Because of maybe it's a substance abuse with their own children.
Well.
So now they have to take on the added burden of becoming a
mm-hmm.
Parent again.
And that's where it's critical that they get some support. So whether they go to a 12-step meeting for families like Al-Anon or Nar-Anon,
mm-hmm.
Which we can get people hooked up with, so that they understand how to deal with their child who has an addiction, but also get some help in how to be a parent again with a younger generation, which is sometimes difficult. they'll be with people who are in the same situation. And so sometimes, for all of us, in any situation, if you're with somebody who understands your circumstances, you feel like they can help you more.
Right, they've been through it.
Right.
Well, a couple other topics, and we have a few minutes left. One is you have guardianship programs. Now, who handles that? Is that Compass?
Compass does guardianships as well as Help Hotline. Okay. Help Hotline also does a payee program. So there's a couple different levels. Guardianships do require that the probate court find a person needs a guardian.
Mm-hmm.
But then there's also payeeship programs where someone who is living independently but needs some help with their finances, their check can go into a payeeship to ensure that their bills are paid first, and then they're kind of given an allowance for the month of what they can spend as free spending money.
Yeah, with that program, is that something that's available for, say, seniors that need that? Or does it have to be a mental health diagnosis? It
has to be a mental health diagnosis or a disability, the payeeship. Guardianship could be for anyone, but that generally happens when a family member or someone is going to take over their affairs because they're unable to complete them or handle their affairs right now.
Right. But I'm thinking of that payeeship program. That's good to know that if it's a disability, again, there are some seniors who, you know, they don't require a full guardianship, but yet they can they need help with bills and doing the finances.
Right, and so the payeeship allows for that to happen. Right. And that's through Help Hotline. 211, again, can hook them up with the right people to talk to about how that works and how to get into it.
With guardianship, this is, through a court proceeding.
Correct.
And again, there are limited, there are sometimes limited guardianship. It doesn't have to be taking care of all of the decisions.
Correct. And that depends on the evidence presented to the judge or the magistrate and really what they feel the person needs, both from the evidence of the family member, but as well as the evidence from a professional who's talked to the person who they're seeking guardianship of.
A couple other things. One, with possible spousal abuse.
Correct.
Again, I know that goes on throughout society, but is that also a possibility or problem sometimes with people over the age of 50?
Happens at every age and every place. And we do provide support for, like, Sojourner House, which is a domestic violence shelter. We work with them through Compass. So there are programs out there. If someone is being abused within the home, whether it's by a spouse or whether it's by a significant other or any family member. So even if it's a caregiver or a child who is abusing a parent they're taking care of, all you have to do is pick up the phone, call 911. If you don't want to call 911 and get law enforcement help, because it's not happening immediately right now, then you can call 211 and get referral information to get out of that situation where that someone that can help you with domestic violence issues, whether it's your spouse, whether it's a significant other, a boyfriend, a girlfriend, or whether it's a caregiver.
So that's where you might work, your staff or the staff of the program might work with Adult Protective Services.
Correct.
Which is through the county.
They could work with Adult Protective Services, which is through Job and Family Services through the county. The Mahoning County Sheriff's Department actually has an officer who deals strictly with these elder abuse issues.
Okay.
And so it's a social worker that's on their staff who will actually help with that. And then we also have the programs like Sojourner and the other houses that deal with this every day and will help a person get out of the situation and into a secure environment.
And then a couple other topics. We only have a couple minutes ago, but I see housing and warm line. That makes me think of, again, maybe seniors in, and this is sort of how we started with, you talked about there are some utility programs, but if somebody is concerned about an elder who, you know, maybe having issues with their housing and heating.
Again, you can go through 211. Our housing programs are for anybody with a disability, especially if that disability is a mental illness. We work on getting people into permanent supportive housing, putting some services around them so that they might have a peer supporter or someone visiting them. The warm line is actually people with mental illness answer the phone. People living in recovery from mental illness answer the phone. Mm-hmm. And if you're lonely or depressed, you can call there and talk with them.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
And talk. It gives you that connection. Gives mm-hmm. you that someone to talk to on the other end of the phone. Mm-hmm. If you don't have a family or friend, you can call. You could call the warm line and talk to someone. And again, 211 could connect you to the warm line.
Well, again, there are just a myriad, a lot.
Yes, there are.
Another word for it. A lot of programs that are available mm-hmm. in the county. We've got a couple minutes to go. Brenda, if you want to kind of sum up again what people need to know, and again, call 211.
Sure. It's basically call 211. They can refer you to services. They can walk you through any of this. They can also give you those volunteer opportunities like we talked about.
Right.
If you're looking for something, excuse me, that you wish to participate in.
Mm-hmm. Now, we're going to, we just had a levy, is that correct? I mean, or is that coming?
Correct. We actually okay. have two levies. They run every 5 years each. Mm-hmm. So we have another one coming up in a couple of years.
Okay.
But we just recently passed a levy last fall mm-hmm. and, last spring, because we didn't run it during the presidential election. And the voters supported us overwhelmingly with a 75% support rate, which we thank everyone for
sure.
their support. And we try to provide as many services as we possibly can for people to access.
Well, hopefully in the past half hour, you've been able to tell all the services that are available for seniors. That's anybody mm-hmm. over 60 or 65 in some cases. But again, call 211. If you do want to contact the Mental Health and Recovery Board, their phone number is 330-746-2959, and they're on West Federal at the Children's Services mm-hmm. Board. Thank you,
Correct.
Brenda, for coming
thank
in.
Thank you.
And again, thank you for watching. This is Senior Focus. I'm Bill Adams. We want to thank Greg Roten and Armstrong's Channel 20 and 100, and also the Austintown Library and the Library System for hosting us today. Till next time. Thanks for watching.
Bread is Armstrong's ongoing initiative to help feed the hungry in our community. To date, food and funds have been distributed to over 20 food banks. These organizations need our support throughout the year. Donations can be made at your local Armstrong office. Also, look for special Breaking Bread events in your area. All efforts benefit area food banks and soup kitchens. For more information, like us on Facebook at facebook.com/ArmstrongOneWire.
Still trying to decide between EXP and satellite? Let's take a look at the facts. Only EXP from Armstrong offers award-winning local customer support and free service calls with no contracts and no early termination fees. EXP also includes Zoom Internet, the area's fastest, plus an intuitive user interface powered by TiVo for the ultimate TV experience. As you can see, when it comes to EXP versus satellite, there's just no comparison. EXP from Armstrong, this changes everything.